Once again, a very big welcome to Penas TV. As we've been constantly updating you about the sudden demise of Prophet TB Joshua, who is one of Nigeria's biggest or world acclaimed man of God. Up until now, we have more updates on it, and then as we've promised to be giving you more updates on all the sudden turn of events in regards to this particular case, we have more and then more updates on this. And the big question that you want to know: what happened? What caused it? When did it even happen, or how true is it? We have all of them here. As we've indicated, we gave an earlier update in our first submission, or our first video that we did in regards to this case, confirming the news and giving you an instance where the church official Facebook page, together with some aides, have publicly come out to acknowledge that indeed the man of God is dead. And what's shocking is that he died today. He was not at the hospital, he died at the church premises. So the big question that you and me and a lot of people want to know is that what happened, how come a man of God who was seen at this church died at this church? What led to it? Was he sick before? Is it the same illness that took him to Turkey? Is it what killed him, or what? Well, today I'm here to give you all the latest updates in regards to this particular case. Now let's start off this way. 2 months or earlier, let me take you back to 3 months. Just last 3 months, we had news that Prophet TB Joshua had stroke. This was the news that we had, and then he was flown to Turkey, which is a country in abroad, obviously, where he was treated and later discharged. So the news that came 2-3 months ago is that Prophet TB Joshua was suffering from stroke, and the good news is he was praying, but then he realized that he needed medical attention. So he was flown to Turkey by his church and himself, and obviously he undergo treatment, and he came back, he was well. We all thank God. Even though he was admitted at the hospital, we believe that the hand of God also played a part in healing him, because doctors are also a hand tool of God. So this man came back. We've seen that over the past 2 months, he's been going about his ministry. He's bold. As you can see, these are just some latest videos from his church service, you know, just few days before his death. It tells you how energetic he was and how well he was doing the work and the service of God. But then today, something shocking happened, and they are saying, per the news that we have it suggests that Saturday, that was yesterday, Prophet TB Joshua was officiating a service at his church. Listen very carefully. Yesterday, Prophet TB Joshua was officiating a service at his church. He officiated the whole service about some few hours, like 1, 2, 3, or 4 hours. But then during that time, he actually left the service and then he went to his apartment. According to sources at the church, they are saying that due to the COVID-19 pandemic, TB Joshua and the management of the church have ordered many people, or many workers and aides, to stay in the house and work from home, so that the virus will not spread, or the church will not be a hub for the virus to spread around and kill people. So many of the aides are working from home, with the exception of few people and the camera crew and the production, who are constantly taking videos of the current activities which are happening at the church. So Prophet TB Joshua, after officiating all of this service, you know, bowed out, or he actually closed that particular bit, that particular bit, which means if he has officiated service for about 3 to 4 hours, I mean, he made the junior pastor to take over, and then he left. So when he left, the perceive or the mindset was that he was going to rest, because there's an apartment at the church for him, where, you know, he can go and sleep, reside, and, you know, go about and forth his normal activities without any harm or anything. So the aides thought Prophet TB Joshua, after preaching vigorously and doing the work of God for 4 hours, he wanted to catch some rest. He wanted to catch some rest and perhaps, you know, take a shower or 1 or 2 and return back to, you know, doing what he loves doing most and what God have ordered him to do. But then they realized that they've been waiting for 1 hour, 2, 3, and they realized Prophet was not coming back. So, you know, the church aides and some pastors rushed. The perceived mindset was, you know, he was still at his apartment, but they went there to knock and, you know, check on the man of God, and they realized the man of God was deeply ill. He felt sadly ill. You notice that I said he was suffering from stroke 2 years, just 2 months ago. He went to Turkey and he came back. So, you know, there was a string or there was a lineage of disease, or he was sick. Maybe he had recovered, but I wouldn't say he had fully recovered. So, and they went to knock on the man of God's door. They entered, they realized that he was not feeling well. I mean, sadly, he was not feeling well. He was sadly ill, and they realized that the way things were going, they needed to rush the man of God to the hospital. But then just before they would send Prophet TB Joshua to the hospital, he died, and we don't know what happened there. Perceivably, we know he had a stroke. He was having a chest service. He went in for some rest. That was the perceived thing. The people left him. They thought he wanted to catch a rest or bath or take a shower and come back. And they realized he was taking too long. When they went, they knocked on his door and realized the man of God was seriously ill, in a very severe condition. They tried to help him, but then just before they would take him to the hospital, he died. And this all happened between the early hours of Sunday, 2 a.m. Yeah, around 2 a.m. And this is a very sad news. The early hours of Saturday, around 2 a.m., the early hours of Sunday, which means this particular morning. And this is a very sad news. And they rushed him to the hospital even after they realized that he was actually dead and stuff. They sent him to the hospital and he was pronounced dead at the hospital around 3 a.m. And this is the official statement which is coming in regards to. Now, before I move on with more detailed analysis in regards or detailed information in regards to this particular case and upcoming thing that is we are getting right here, one of Lagos Police Commissioner CP, that's Hakeem Odomosu, have said or made a statement about Prophet TB Joshua's death news or sudden demise, and he has actually confirmed that this is true. Indeed, the prophet was pronounced dead at the hospital around 3 a.m. And as we said, the circumstances surrounding his death was that he felt uncomfortable whilst officiating a service. He went to the apartment. People thought he was going to just catch a rest. They realized he was not coming. They went in. They realized he was sadly ill. Just before they would bring him or take him to the hospital, the man of God passed away. Even though he passed away, they sent him to the hospital, and he was pronounced dead at the hospital around 3 a.m. just this dawn. So this is a very sad thing of events that we are gathering that led to Prophet TB Joshua's death. He had a stroke. He was treated in Turkey. He came back, and this had it. Up to now, the hospital that Prophet TB Joshua currently his remains is, they are saying they are going to conduct a postmortem to see. You know, we all know postmortem, when somebody dies, they do a series of this experiment or a series of tests on the person. You know, they cut the person into half and all that to check what killed the person and the possible cause of death. Sometimes it could, so that police can know if it was not a homicide, a murder, or a suicide. They want to know all of this, and then they are saying with immediate effect they've started investigation. They've started working on Prophet TB Joshua's remains to conduct an autopsy on him for them to know the actual cause. Was it a heart attack? Was it a liver failure, a lung failure? Was it a high blood pressure, or perhaps the stroke that he had led or triggered another form of heart attack that made the man of God left or died in such a very sudden and mysterious manner? Remember, it was just a week to his 58th birthday. He was 57, just a week for him to celebrate his 58th birthday, then he died. And then this is a very sad turn of events that we are getting in regards to this particular case. Now, just before we take leave of you, Prophet TB Joshua is married. He is married with three kids. And then as I'm speaking to you, the information that we are gathering is that the wife is in so much tears that the church has to rush to her aid to console her and sympathize with her, because some of the children themselves, when they announced to them that their father had passed, they were shocked. Say, how could this have happened? When did this happen, and what led to it? Because the whole thing is shocking. Perhaps I'm speaking to you now. The family have asked for privacy, and then Bishop TB have asked for privacy. That Bishop TB Joshua, the days to come, they are putting things together for his funeral and all his passing rites and all of that. They just want privacy. Now, before I leave you, let me give you a little background story of Prophet TB Joshua. Prophet TB Joshua, he was living good, or his family was quite good, and up until somewhere around 10 years when his father died. So when his father died, he was left in the care of the mother, but the mother, things were not going on so well. So, you know, he needed to go and stay with one of his uncles where he began school. And then in the school that he was in the midst of Muslims, you know, so he was the only Christian there. And at a point in time, he said in his 1989 biography that he had to at a point in time, he had to go and hide under a mango tree to read the Bible because he loved the Bible so much. But he realized the conditions surrounding the school wasn't favorable, and even money for him to keep up with the education wasn't there. So he had to go and search for a job, and the job that he found, shockingly, was among we Ghanaians, because that time was when many Ghanaians had gone to Nigeria to seek for greener pastures. Yes, the Ghana-Nigeria revolution that brought about the whole Ghana must go through. So Prophet TB Joshua joined a field of Ghanaians there, and that particular business that most Ghanaians were doing is that they were picking cock or hen, their feces, I would say their droppings, and they were using it for manure in various farmings. And all of the people who were doing those jobs at that time, at that particular place that he was, were Ghanaians. He was the only Nigerian amongst all of them. He did that for some time. He picked the hen droppings with his hands and put it in a plastic bag, which will be used for manure in various other farms. So obviously he did that, he gathered some money and went back to school. But this was how Prophet TB Joshua's whole ministry started. Whilst in school one day, they realized that a madman had barged into their class. And the madman who had barged into the class, he was noted to be very aggressive in nature, and somebody who will hurt you or harm you. So, you know, many of the students were afraid, and obviously the teacher, together with the student, all of them ran away from the class through the windows and other exit areas in that particular class. It was left with only TB Joshua, Prophet TB Joshua. At that time, he was not a prophet. And then he prayed for the madman, and then he cast out the demon of that particular madman. The madman was calm. He spoke to him good. He wasn't aggressive anymore. The aggressiveness that he barged into the class with, he didn't continue with that same aggressiveness. So when people came out, they were shocked. They said, "Hey, henceforth, we are going to call you a young bishop." So that was how the ministry started. He finished school. Finished senior secondary school, then he started in ministry bit by bit, and through the revolution and the handiwork of God, today his ministry has become one of the biggest ministry in Nigeria, in the whole wide world. In fact, at a point in time on YouTube, just before his church platform was suspended on YouTube, you will realize that among all the ministry, church ministries, his platform was the most watched. And aside from that too, he commands a lot of authority. He's a manual TV and affiliate networks that watch him or run 24/7. Aside from all of these things too, what we know is that when